to Warner Christian Academy and Elementary's Christmas concert. We are so excited that you're here. My name is Michael Chambliss. I'm the lead pastor here at Whitechapel Church, and I'm also the president of Warner Christian Academy. And I just want to take a second and say thank you for allowing us the privilege of being able to partner with you and educating your child so that they discover truth, capital T truth. We know that that's Jesus. In academics, athletics, and the arts. It is what we believe a sacred honor, and we thank you so much for the privilege of being able to partner with you. A couple of things right quick before we dive in. I want to ask everyone to find a seat. There's still some seats up in the balcony. There's some seats, a few seats in the back. And we want to keep all the aisles clear because there is going to be a change in the choirs. And so the kids will be using the aisles. So if you could find a seat and keep the aisles clear, that would be appreciated. And also, we know that everyone wants to take photos. We are going to ask you to stay in your seat to take those photos, if you would, though. And so just be cognizant of the people that are around you. So stay where you're at and do everything you can to get the best photos right where you're at. And before we begin, though, we want to start with a word of prayer before our students lead us to celebrate the birth of Christ. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for the privilege of being able to gather together here tonight and the freedom that we have to do so. We are so blessed to be able to gather together as the elementary school for Warner Christian Academy to celebrate your gift to the world, Jesus Christ. I thank you so much for these students and their families. We thank you for this music program and all the hard work that these students have put in to prepare for tonight. I just pray and ask, Lord, for each one of these students, as well as their teachers, that you would just calm their nerves and that you would let them perform to the best of their abilities so that everything that is said and done here tonight would bring glory and honor to your name. Lord, we thank you again for your gift of salvation that was born that we celebrate this time of year. And we truly do tonight celebrate you and pause to give you thanks and welcome your presence here. We ask all of this in Jesus' name. Amen.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. He was with God in the beginning. In him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. His light shines in the darkness, and the darkness cannot overcome it. John 1, 1-5.
Thank you. I While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no kitchen available for them.
An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for I bring you good news that will cause great joy among the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths in a manger." Luke 2:1-12.
So they found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger.
When they had found him, they spread the word concerning what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them.
But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. Luke 2:13-20.
Mother, and mercy, my
coming among us. The glory of the one and only Son that came from the Father, full of grace and truth. John 1, verse 4.
Thank you.
for him to quench the burning wars and pour the wine and light. Long ago, the hand of Christ was nailed upon a tree, but still, the Holy Church redeemed the hearts of you and me.
Thank you. born of woman, born under the law,
to redeem those who were under the law,
so that we might receive adoption as sons and daughters. Galatians chapter 4, verse 4 and 5.
No, we want to in service hours this evening, passing out bulletins, running the camera. We did record this. It's not going to be like, you know, the world's greatest recording, but it's going to be something, and we will put it up on our website, so if you want to send that to your families that didn't make it tonight, you can do that. But let's give our student volunteers a round of applause.